the position of the doctor at the right side facing our patient.
Yes.
Once again, we must inspect the abdomen. We have talked about the assessing of the esophagus the previous class, or not?
Yes.
So let's repeat the esophagus signs. The first, the form of the abdomen. Mm-hmm. What is the form of the abdomen? Mm-hmm. When esophagus. If patient have has fluid effusion in the abdomen.
Stricken.
When he is standing, the form.
Normal standing.
Normal.
No. When a patient has a fluid effusion in the abdomen, okay. When he is standing, the form of the abdomen is like a pier.
Yes.
So they are increased to the bottom.
Mm-hmm.
And when he is lying, the fluid
yes.
comes to the lateral yes. regions,
mm-hmm.
and the form of the abdomen, frog belly, is called frog belly. Mm-hmm. So this is the first sign of the esophagus. The second, we may assess the esophagus by percussion. So we percute from the umbilicus to the lateral region,
mm-hmm.
and normally the patient have tympanic sound everywhere, and if he has a fluid, we have a region of the dull sound,
mm-hmm.
here and here. Then we may ask our patient to lay the right side, patient side, and fluid will come to here. So while percussing from the left lateral region to the right lateral region, normally we must have tympanic sound everywhere, and in patient with fluid effusion, here will be the tympanic sound and then dull sound due to the fluid. Fine, and once more technique. We lay our palm to the right lateral region, and by fingers we rest the left lateral region. If the patient have fluid diffusion, our palm will feel the vibrations. In this case, there is no fluid diffusion, and my palm doesn't feel the vibrations. So this is the assessing of esophagus. Now we will percute the liver sizes. In our department, we assess the liver sizes by percussion by Kurlov. There are other techniques of percuting percussion of the liver, but in our department, we use the technique by Kurlov. So we need to assess three sizes. The first size by the medio-clavicular line, the second size by the midline, and the third size by the left costal arch. So we must percute the first size from the top to the bottom, from the second intercostal space, from the clear pulmonary sound to the dull sound. Like lungs. He is the absolute liver dullness. So we count the sixth rib, and we mark the border at the side of the finger shifted to the clear pulmonary sound. Here, the first point. The second point, we're percussing. Give me a pen, please. So the second point we must perfect by the medioclavicular line from the right inguinal region, from the bottom to the top, from the tympanic sound to the dull sound. Magda wooden at the side of the finger shifted to the tympanic sound. So the first size must be 9 centimeters plus minus 1 centimeter. In this case we have 8 centimeters. So the first size may be 8, 9, 10 centimeters. 9 centimeters plus minus 1. Then this border we put to the middle line here, mark it. And then we percuse from the navel to this border. And mark here. The second size. The second size must be 8 centimeters plus minus 1 centimeter. In this case, they are equal, 8 and 8. The third size, we are percuting by left costal arch to this point. This is the third size of the liver. This is the liver. The third size may be 7 centimeters plus minus 1 centimeter. In this case, this is 6 centimeters. So 8 centimeters, 8 and 6 in this case. Normally 9, 8, 7 plus minus 1 centimeter. So this is normal liver. Have you any questions about this?
No.
Now split, percuting of the split. We ask our patient to lay the right side. This arm to put to the right shoulder and legs. The right leg must be reflexed and left leg must be flexed. Flex it like this. This is the right position. So we have two sizes of the spleen. One size we establish by the midi axillary line, and the second size by the 10th intercostal space. So the first, we must start from the 3rd intercostal space from and percuting from clear pulmonary sound till dull sound. Mark the border at the side of the finger shifting to the clear sound. Then by the midi axillary line we percuse from the iliac. Yeah. This is the first size. The first size may be 6 centimeters plus minus 1 centimeter. In this case, 5 centimeters. Then we find the 10th intercostal space, this here, and percuse from the navel in the direction of the 10th intercostal space. Sound and from the back. The second size may be 4 centimeters plus minus 1 centimeter. In this case 5 centimeters. 5 centimeters to 5 centimeters. This is the spleen. Have you any questions about it?
No.
Then ask our patient to lay the spine.
Which
and we will palpate the liver.
Back.
Beth. No, no. Palpating the liver. For palpating the liver, we must use our both hands. One hand must fix the right costal arch. This is the end of costal arch, so your finger and your palm must be 3 centimeters below the arch. Then by the right hand, we put our right hand in the right inguinal region and ask our patient to inhalate and exhalate. Inhalate by the abdomen. We make a fold, inhalate, exhalate, with pressing, inhalate, exhalate, and inhalate. So while inhalating, the diaphragm goes down, and the liver goes down, and your fingers may feel the lower edge, lower margin of the liver. Understand? So once again, we fix the right costal arch and ask our patient to inhalate and exhalate. Inhalate, we make a fold, exhalate, pressing. Inhalate, exhalate. Inhalate, exhalate, and inhalate. And while exhalating, I feel the margin, the lower margin of the liver. The lower margin of the liver must be painless, smooth, and movable. So it must move during inhalation. The palpation of the spleen. It may be palpated in this position and in position at the right side of the patient. In this position, we fix the left costal arch, and we must palpate in the direction from the novel to the 10th intercostal space, in this direction. So we put our hand and ask the patient inhalate and exhale. Inhalate, exhalate. Inhalate, exhalate, inhalate, and during inhalation I can palpate the spleen. But normally in healthy patients we can't palpate the spleen. Why? The right side. Why we can't palpate normal spleen? We percuted it here, and the end of the left costal arch is here, so the mobility of the during the inhalation of the spleen is not so much, so the spleen can go to here. So normally, if the spleen is not enlarged, we can't it palpate. We can palpate spleen only if it is enlarged. For example, such size of the spleen. This is the end of the costal arch. So our patient is inhalating, spleen moving here, and I can it palpate. Understand? So normally, spleen is not palpable. So palpating spleen at the right side of the patient, we fix the left costal arch and palpate from the novel to the 10th intercostal space. Inhalate, exhalate. Inhalate, exhalate, and inhalate. No, it is not palpating, it is good. Laying the back. So, have you any questions about palpation? Liver palpation, spleen palpation. Is clear for you? Clear. So, gallbladder science. The science of the gallbladder diseases. For the first, we must find the gallbladder point. The gallbladder point is situated. So, we must find the right coastal arch here, and the external side of the musculus rectus of abdominis. So here is the gallbladder point. Normally we can't palpate the gallbladder, but sometimes when a patient has, for example, malignancy of the pancreas, and pancreas obturates the bile duct, the gallbladder becomes increased in size and tenderness. So in this case, we may palpate the gallbladder. This sign will be called Courvoisier-Terrier sign. You must know the sign, the description of this sign, the diagnostic value of each sign, and the name of the sign. So the first sign, Courvoisier-Terrier sign, this sign, its diagnostical value, the malignancy of the pancreas, the obturation of the bile duct, and the description of this sign, we may palpate the gallbladder. The next sign, Vasilenko sign. We ask our patient to inhalate, make a deep breath, and percuse at this point, exhalate. If our patient feels pain at the deep breath while we percuting, this is the sign of cholecystitis, so acute inflammation of gallbladder. The next sign, the Carey sign. So we ask our patient to inhalate and press in the gallbladder point, exhalate. If our patient feels pain while pressing at inhalation, this is the sign, so the diagnostical value of this sign, acute cholecystitis 2. Murphy sign. We put our thumbs like this under the costal arch and ask our patient to inhalate, pressing. And if our patient feels pain, he stopped breathing. This sign of the acute cholecystitis 2. The next sign, the sign Ortner's-Grekov sign. We must breathe by the costal arches, and our patient may feel pain at the right side if he has an inflammation of the liver. And the last sign, Frenikos Georgievsko-Musi sign. We must press between the legs of sternocleidomastoideus muscle here at the right. Frenikos nerve is coming here. So in the case of acute cholecystitis, our patient will feel the pain. That's all for today. Any questions? No. Once again, you train these skills and repeat light and deep palpation. Okay?